Everybody, how you doing today? It's me again, Sadio Leke. I'm back in the building, Think Positive Incorporated. Today's gonna be a nice day. It's kind of nice and sunny, so I want you guys to sit back and enjoy the show. Because this is called the Break Your Plexus Show, baby. Why am I getting all excited? You're probably sitting back like, this guy's crazy, right? Because maybe he doesn't know what the Break Your Plexus is all about. I know what the Break Your Plexus is all about. It's the most dreaded thing every medical student hates. They can't stand it. Like, my God, I gotta know all this nerves. It's ridiculous. Relax, okay? Relax. You know why I'm telling you that? Because by the time I'm done with the show, you're gonna be sitting back like, you know what? I wanna be like that guy, man. I'm not smart. I've just seen it so many times. That's the difference. If you do it more than enough times, think about it. I'm going to give you a little short story. Remember the first time you learned how to drive a car? If you do, all right, you look at the steering, you try to look for the gear, you're like, man, I don't know where the brakes are. Even if it's a stick shift, it's even worse, right? But now, you're probably driving, you could close your eyes driving in your sleep. But why? Because you drive every day, and there's no secret behind these guys. It's not hard. It's easy, and I'm going to make it look easy to you. So the first thing I want to implore you to do first is to learn how to draw the damn thing. You know what? If you don't know the structure, how can you understand the clinical application? Because I'm going to talk purely clinical, because the way I'm going to literally put it to you, I want you to not just know the nerves, but we're going to talk about what the nerve does, what muscle it's hitting, what happens when it's not working. That's called pathology, right? So let's get all excited. Yeah! Exactly. All right. So what is the brachial plexus? Brachial means arm. What? Exactly. Yeah. I do break dance too. So I'm not really one of the typical boring medical student. But I'm not going to dance on this show. What's going to happen is I want you to read in anticipation to realize this is your body. Okay? So, first thing, you have your own brachial plexus. Some of my medical students just read and they forget. You know what? They actually read it by themselves. It's funny, right? All right. The brachial plexus is a bunch of nerves, right? Coming from your cervical vertebrae, right about around C5. So, if I look down here, let me see here. See, this is my C7. Can you see that? Actually, I'm sorry, T1, because it doesn't move. The one that moves. Oh, there you go. C7. C6. C5. That's where your brachial plexus starts. It starts at C5. Runs all the way to T1. It's a bunch of nerves that's basically coming out of your brain. Of your spinal cord. Coming out as a bunch of spinal nerves. And innervating everything right here. In your arms. Right? All these little trickle things you can kind of, you know, break. I know, if you can't break, that's fine. Right, doing this, doing that, right, doing this, that. It's all brachial plexus. You use it every day, but you gotta think like it, man. All right, so the first thing I want you to do is I want to recommend you go on Google right now and type in learn brachial plexus in 5 minutes. It's a little, you know, PDF file. A doctor made it. I don't know his name by the top of my head, but look at that. I'm going to break it down for you, but if you use that to kind of quickly learn, he'll speed up your process of learning. So let's start by drawing the brachial plexus. The first thing I want you to realize is you have a brain and you have a spinal cord. So let's be clear where these things are coming from, okay? And every spinal cord has its own levels. Okay? So I'm going to call this C5. These are C6, C7, C8, T1. As you can see, you have the 8th cervical nerve, but you only have 7 cervical vertebrae. From your anatomy class, you probably realize all these nerves kind of come on top of each other, so you have the 8th actual cervical nerve. This is easy, guys. Let's start. The brachial plexus is divided into roots. The roots, just like a tree, if you uproot a plant, it has a root. So, kind of inverted root, but let's start like this by drawing it out. So it starts with a V, just like I drew it, right? So we're going to start by drawing a Y-shaped looking line like that. You see the Y, beautiful. And you draw another Y, but this time it's inverted. Can you see that? Then you draw another Y. You see, I love metaphors for one thing. You can make it look as stupid as you can. Look, there's three Y's. Did you ever notice that? Now, one Y is facing this way, the other Y. So if you can just draw a Y, I think literally you can pull this off. Anybody can do this, guys. Then, another V. You know what? I like this drawing because a lot of people never see this. This is actually a rocket. Look. I can put a little rocket launcher there. Another rocket launcher here. See that? This kind of looks cute, right? It's kind of about to launch a whole space rocket. Bam! I'm like, what? But I'm not going to. It's just for fun. I like to make medicine fun. Anything. I like to have a lot of fun. Right? Can you see how easy that is? Then basically add a couple of lines, you know, like a W. 1, 2. Do you see my W? It goes up, That's my W. That's really important that you know that. Extremely important, right? Because we're going to name this now. See how easy it is to draw. If you do that, you're already ahead of the game. Now, we have roots, like I said. So, you know, I'm going to break the roots down. Did you see that? So, roots. After a root, what do you think is next? I love medicine. Trunks, right? Trunks. There's really nothing going on with your trunk, so you leave them alone. So, trunks are boring. Everybody cuts every tree by the trunk, right? Bam, you just got, oh, why did you cut the trunk? It was staring at me. Then, there's divisions. Right? And this division is just telling you there's a multiplication table. Right? Can you see that? It's just an X. Right? Or, and you can just draw one here. It's like a Z. X, Z. This is how a letter is. It's just almost like, wow! What was I thinking? I'll tell you how useless these guys are immediately, as soon as possible, because I don't like students think they're actually important. And they're chords. These guys are chords. And the last guys are called the branches. Very, very easy. But guess why I'm here, guys? Mnemonics, baby! I want you to ruin Rob Trunks division. It's a waste of time. So I'm going to just call it Robert Treat Drinks Cold Beer. What? Yeah, that's how you remember it. Robert Treat Drinks Cold Beer. And that's it. If you like beer, good. Remember, in my Port Potential election, don't drink too much. And don't drink and drive. That pisses me off. You kill a lot of people, and I have to take care of them. All right. Now, I told you that C5, you know what? I want to make sure we're on the same page so you can actually see this is where C5 is. This is C6, 7, good, point to 8, and to T1. Are we on point? Good. Now, let me give you a good piece of advice. See all these guys here? This X and Z? That's what throws students off because they're focusing on this area. And you're like, man, oh man, oh man. It's useless. The only time you actually ever really need it, if you ever open a body, and you kind of like, I know what, let me look weird. There's really no nerve that's important. But, hey. We gotta make this a little complex and better. Right? Yeah, a little bit, but I don't care. Now, let's start putting up the nerves. The first thing I want you to do is right here, just draw a little line. And at this point, you can call that, we're not gonna name that yet. Let's just put a line here. Let's put another line here. And one line here. Hope you can see it. We're going to fill them up in a minute. Three lines here in the middle.
Hey, thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you learned a lot. Are you studying for the USMLE Step 1 or Step 2? Are you studying for the NCLEX or you're currently in nursing school as a nursing student? Are you a PA student currently in school or studying for your PANCE exam? Or are you a nurse practitioner student or trying to take your MP board exam, listen, I've got super awesome content for you. If you truly love this video and it simplified your learning process, I want you to check out my website below. I've listed all the list of exams, whether you're studying for any of these board exams, and all I want you to do is click on the link right now below so that you can take you directly to my website. For USMLE, just go to smashusmle.com. For NCLEX, go to crushnclex.com. And if you're studying for the PANS exam, the nurse practitioner exam, or you're studying for your internal medicine board exam, just click below and take you directly to ftplectures.com. Listen, I can't wait to help you. If you need to get in touch with me, just get to my website, be able to reach me directly, and we can work together one-on-one. Listen, you are super awesome, and my goal here is to help your dream come true. If you want to be a doctor, want to be a nurse practitioner, a registered nurse or physician assistant, I'm here to help you get to that next level. With your medical knowledge, let's save the world together. I love you guys. You guys are super awesome. And do not forget to click on the link below to be able to get to my website. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. You guys have a great day. Let's go.